As of October 22, 2023, there are currently 46 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet. One of these erupting volcanoes is the Mayon volcano in the Philippines, which is continuing an eruption that is now in its 106th day, sending tumbling lava avalanches down its steep slopes, which are visible from a fairly large distance. However, this eruption, which has kept the volcano at an alert level of 3, has so far also generated several dozen pyroclastic flows, hence the 6-kilometer exclusion zone around its summit in all directions. With this being said, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In Russia, a major explosive eruption occurred via paroxysm at the infamous Bezymianny volcano, whose name translates to unnamed. Meanwhile, in Alaska, there was a major change of the still-erupting Shishaldin volcano, suggesting that for the short term, its eruptions might become less explosive. And, in what is this week's top story, a partial closure was made on a section of a volcano within the United States due to increased volcanic activity. This closure occurred on Hawaii's Big Island at the Kilauea volcano, specifically two trails along its southwest rift zone, which, in the last month, has seen two episodes of seismic unrest. The first episode occurred between September 24th and October 10th, where a magmatic intrusion occurred into the connector region of Kilauea's southwest rift zone, which pushed the overlying ground upwards by 10 centimeters or approximately 3.9 inches. This intrusion eventually ceased but resulted in 1,200 earthquakes. However, it appears that this intrusion restarted again on October 16th, resulting in a temporary increase in the rate of earthquakes by 343%. While this seismic activity subsequently decreased, there is still an elevated rate of earthquakes occurring at shallow depths in Kilauea's southwest rift zone. Thus, due to a slightly increased risk of an eruption occurring in that section of Kilauea's southwest rift zone, or, more likely, in the southwest section of Kilauea's summit caldera, both the Mauna Iki and Ka'u desert trails were closed off. Meanwhile, in Russia, a short yet violent burst of activity referred to as a paroxysm occurred at the Bezymianny volcano, resulting in the creation of an ash plume that shot up to a height of 35,000 feet or 10.7 kilometers. This explosive event occurred at 4:20 p.m. local time on October 18th, where a partially sustained eruption column lasted for approximately 30 minutes. The ash plume from this eruption drifted towards the north-northeast, causing some minor amounts of ash to fall on the town of Klyuchi. However, satellites subsequently detected abundant thermal signatures from Bezymianny's eastern slope, indicating that a fairly long pyroclastic flow occurred. During the paroxysm, a 6.8 kilometer or 4.2 mile long pyroclastic flow was generated, incinerating what little if any vegetation there was over an area of 5 square kilometers. While the paroxysm that occurred was smaller than a similar event on April 7, 2023, it appears that it occurred due to the same mechanism. Simply put, significant pressure and gas had built up underneath its post-1956 collapsed lava dome until it reached a critical point that caused the overlying dome to fracture, generating a powerful volcanic explosion. And, in Alaska, it appears that a change has occurred in the exact nature of the Shishaldin volcano's still ongoing eruption. As, after 3 months of producing powerful paroxysms every few days to weeks that caused ashfall in nearby communities and eruption columns up to 45,000 feet in height, this cyclical activity has seemingly ceased. Specifically, a paroxysm has not occurred at this volcano since October 3rd, and this occurred alongside several other changes. Instead of dropping to low levels before the next significant explosive event, both seismic activity and, more importantly, gas emissions have remained elevated. This suggests the volcanic gas is now escaping at a higher rate because the eruptive conduit of Shishaldin is now open. In other words, significant volumes of rock, lava, and other debris is not blocking its summit eruptive conduit, meaning that only small explosive events are likely during this current, less explosive phase of activity. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on October 21st of 2023. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.